Hey foodie friends. So if you recall, I joined Sam's Club just a couple few days ago to get this in particular. I looked everywhere online. I could not find king crab legs anywhere. Whether you go get them or you could have them delivered. You could have them delivered, but it was like $80 a pound or some ridiculous amount. So these things are monstrous. As you see, how long compared to me. And then you can pick out different ones. This one has a massive claw. So let's take them out and take a look. So 2 pounds was only $40. Basically, they were $20 a pound on sale, $10 off per package, $40 per package. Now, did that include the weight of this little bit of garlic butter? They call it scampi butter. I don't know. I would weigh it on my scale, but it's just too watery, too messy. I normally make my own butter, but I'm gonna go ahead and try this just to see how it is, let you know if it's any good. But these monsters, I mean, this thing is so heavy, it's amazing. They pre-split them, so it should be a little easier to get into. They're split on both sides, so that makes it easier to split in half. Usually if I have the scissors, I cut it up one side and up the other. So we're going to go ahead and lightly boil them. You could steam them. I'm just going to lightly boil them. Hopefully they'll fit in a pot. I had to thaw them out just so I can bend them enough to get into a pot. And I don't think I've ever had king crab legs this big, ever. I think I did a king crab leg way back when. They were from Argentina. They were more fishy, not as good. But the cool thing is, you just saw in the picture, these are from Russian waters, which basically is up off of Alaska. So this should be really good. They smell good. They're not fishy at all. They smell really fresh. I can't wait to try them. Okay, so I'm getting the crab legs started. Remember, we're just gonna heat them because they're already pre-cooked. We don't want to overcook them, but I did taste test it ahead of time because I noticed it says crab legs and salt. They've added a lot of salt to this crab leg. So I rinsed it a few times and then hopefully given a light boil will cook some of that salt out. There was no reason to add salt to it. So that's my only complaint so far. And I'm just starting to melt their scampi butter. It looks kind of a little bit strange looking, but almost looks like mayonnaise, but we'll wait till it melts. We'll give it a try. So while I'm waiting on the scampi butter to melt and the crabs to kind of heat up so that they're ready to eat, tell me if you tried these before by Aqua Star. If you've gotten them at Sam's Club or where you've gotten them before and how you liked them. So when it comes to king crab legs, I like to use these. They're big, heavy duty, like crab cutting scissors or chicken cutting scissors for getting through bones and stuff. I use these. I got these really nice crab crackers years ago. I think I had to order them online. Nice and heavy, not the little cheapies. And then my husband got closet rods. We learned from a crab house that you can just do closet rods. Cut them up. Works really good on blue crab, but it works on any crab too. It kind of keeps the shell from just splattering all over the place, because sometimes when you crush it with one of these, shells just get shattered. With this, you just give it a good whack, and then it cracks nice and clean. Also, if you see my past crab videos, when you got to really get in there and get something out of a shell and you don't want to split it, like say the knuckles, they had some knuckles in here, you just get that in there and pull the meat out with the top of a spoon or even a fork. I have decided I'm going to pre-taste test their scampi butter. It smells good. It's got a lot going on in there though. And I looked at the ingredients and it's a lot of ingredients. But let's give it a little taste test. That's really good. Very good. And I'd have to look at the sodium level, but my guess is it's probably not low. But it's very tasty. You see little bits of what appears to be garlic in there. Yeah, looks like garlic, and I'd have to look at the ingredients, but maybe dill weed or something. I'm not really sure. All kind of stuff. Delicious. So as you see, I'm heating it just till it just starts to bubble and boil. We don't want to cook it at all. We just want to reheat it. Okay, it's steamy hot, but it's not overcooked. So let's give it a try. Got the scampi butter that they provided with it. So I'm gonna tackle this massive claw second, but let's go for the leg first. And whenever I have had king crab, never this big, the trick is just use a couple paper towels and protect your fingers. So I'm gonna break away the knuckles like this. Oh, now that I've broken away the knuckle, actually I should be able to just do this. Watch. Ooh, that's hot. Just hot enough. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Beautiful. So you want to make sure that you don't eat the cartilage. See the cartilage? My friend Danny the Medic, if you've heard of Danny the Medic, if you haven't, look him up. He's hilarious. Anyways, he called this the plastic. When we were eating seafood one day, we were having crabs, blue crabs, and he says, don't eat the plastic. I'm gonna try it without the scampi butter first. It's very good, it's very meaty. It's still very salty though. Saltier than I would prefer. There was no reason for them to add salt. Look how meaty that is. It's beautiful. All right, let's try it with the scampi butter. That makes it really magical. That's some good scampi butter. We're gonna step out front and see what the husband thinks. He's been working in the yard all day. He's kind of hot and tired, a little bit hungry. Let's see if he likes it. Okay, so do a little dip in that scampi butter. It's very good. Tell me what you think.
It's okay.
Is it a little salty?
I don't think so, but I mean, it tastes like crab.
He's not a big seafood lover like I am. So we're gonna try this knuckle. Look at the size of this monster. This knuckle alone could be almost a meal for somebody. I'm really digging this butter though, so I'm gonna dip it in that. The knuckle is really good. It's very meaty, a little on the tough side, but this is, again, a massive crab. Probably the smaller you go, the more tender it is. It's quite good. Let's do a slow-mo on this. All right, here's a biggie. I'm gonna attempt to get into this claw. Look at the size of this claw. They did like a little cut mark. A little cut mark on this side. This is gonna be tough. I might have to get my crab crackers. Just beat the heck out of this thing. Turn it over. Oh, look at that. Look at the steam. Look at that, it's beautiful. The fact that they pre-cracked it definitely helps me get it all the way open. All right, let's see what it's all about in here. There's that cartilage. The plastic, don't eat it. Mmm, cheers. Mmm. Mmm. That is so good. And it's not as salty for some reason as the other parts. Interesting. Mmm. I think it's just best to go in with your fingers and go for it. Mmm. Mmm. That's my favorite part. The claw. I figured it would be the leg. It's just so light and seems like it's more tender. You'd think it'd be tougher than the leg. Not as salty. It's like the perfect balance. Remember, I didn't add any seasonings. You're not going to want to add any seasoning, but if you want to, or you want to put your garlic sauce all over the shell and then open it, go for it. But it's got plenty of flavor. Mmm. Mmm. Mmm, 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 mmm. So if you like these kind of videos, whether it be seafood, beef, chicken, whatever, eating out at restaurants, doing reviews, making something at home, it would be an honor to have you subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.